Making Markdown scalable has been an issue that has been talked about and tried to be solved over the years. When I worked at Tina CMS, that was our goal. Make Markdown scalable. Now Astro is also taking on this space by introducing content collection. With the introduction of content collections, we now have ability to organize, validate, and even have type safety with Markdown. The first thing we need to do is use the reserved content folder in our source directory so that Astro knows we want to use content collections. So let's create a content folder here, and we'll create a blog, and we'll create one more just so we can see the layout, and we'll call it newsletter. Now inside of each one of these is where you can put all of your Markdown files or MDX files. So let's create a file here called firstblog.md. Now we need to create our schemas. And the way that we do that is we define a config.typescript file in the content folder. The first thing we need to do is import Z and define collection from Astro. Import Z is Zod. If you don't know what Zod is, click the link in the top right now, and it will take you to a video talking about what Zod is and how it works. But you'll see a little bit of it in this video. Next, we need to actually define our collection here. We need to create our schema object. So we do schema z.object. And inside of this object, we can put all of our front matter that we expect to be here. So I expect there to be a title, and that'll be a z.string. Maybe I expect an image, so we can do image z.string, but I want it to be optional, so I can do dot optional and then hit save. Now we have a schema. Now we just need to export that schema out so we can use it somewhere else. Now we've exported our schema here, we can use it wherever we need to. So we're going to use the index.astro here to just grab all of the different blog posts that we might have. So we can do that by first importing get collection from Astro, then importing our blog collection that we already defined in our config. And then we can use this blog entry wherever we need to. So we can use it to map over right here. So we do blog entry.map, and we can show the title for each one. And at this point, this is ready to be shown. But what I want to show you is type safety that comes along with this. So if, for example, we thought blog entry dot, and then instead of slug, we try and put something else in like description, and we hit save, what you'll see is a red squiggly and it says property description does not exist on type collection entry blog. So now we can say, oh, we meant slug, hit save, and now we're good to go. So now if we go ahead and run this, and we go to localhost 3000, you can see, hello world, it's me, that's the title. And if we click this link right now, we get 404 not found, and that's because we haven't actually set up our blog here with dynamic routing. So let's go ahead and set that up next. So from here, we can create a new folder, we'll call it blog, and then inside of that, we'll just create a new file, and we'll call it slug, and that variable will be dynamic. And then what we can do is use get static paths so that when we statically generate, it fills in all the data so that everything is ready to go. First, we'll import get collection again. Then we'll use get static paths, just like in Next.js, if you've seen it. Then we'll, inside of our get static paths, we'll use our blog entries, just like we had in our previous index.astro right here, this blog entries. We'll do the same thing. Then we'll map over these and return a path for each one. Then finally, we'll use astro props to get the entry and then the content as well. And so the entry holds all of the front matter, and then the content is anything inside the body. So what we can do now is do an H1 with that title, and then use this slot right here to have all of the rest of the code. So now this is ready to go. We can open it up in our application and take a look at what happens. Now we're back on our site. We can now click our link and it takes us to this page. Now let's look at what happens if we accidentally add in a property that is not part of our schema. We're inside our blog here and I'm gonna add a new one called description. Then what I'm going to do is restart the dev server. And as you can see down here right now, the data here, it doesn't have that description. Even though it's in there as a description, it's not showing up as part of our data. Now, if I go back to my config here and add it in, so we can just say description z.string, comma, restart the dev server. You can see now the data is being returned with that description. This allows you to essentially have protection against adding in things that you don't actually need right out of the gate. So there you have it, a first look at Astro's content collections. If you made it this far in the video, YouTube's gonna recommend you a video here. Algorithm driven, so click it. And if you're not subscribed, why not? Click right here.